creative industries have emerged as one of the leading sectors in the economy.
Starting up a small recording studio in my dad's garage, it's all it took.
My story was more like experimenting with a variety of flavors, baking cupcakes, brownies, donuts.
Breakthroughs are usually when you find a new way to do something.
Oh well, me and my sister set up a fashion label because we just couldn't find what we wanted in shops.
Breaking rules and great stories start with how you dare to do things differently.
So, how do you start and sustain a business?
All these and more as Africa's Global Bank, UBA, presents Mind Your Own Business, a radio program designed to initialize, educate, and motivate young entrepreneurs emerging as strong players in the local and global economy. Stay tuned for Mind Your Own Business, proudly brought to you by UBA, Africa's Global Bank.
This is Mind Your Own Business, brought to you by UBA, Africa's Global Bank.
Good morning. Welcome to Mind Your Own Business, brought to you by UBA, Africa's Global Bank. I'm Wole Famiroa. Thank you for joining us today. We bring you valuable insights from some of Nigeria's boldest and smartest entrepreneurs. They are here to not only inspire, but to educate you and let you know what it takes to be a successful business person in this country. On our program today, we bring you a guest that is invested in Nigeria's arts and culture. Quite unique indeed. So you don't want to miss her story. She is the founder and CEO of Terra Culture and BAP Productions, Bolanle Austin Peters. Bolanle, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you. It's an honor to be here.
All right. So we need to hear more about your story. Terra Culture is a big part of it, but I also know that you're the lead producer of the upcoming film, 93 Days. We'll get to that later on. But let's start with Terra Culture. Just tell us the genesis of that business. Where did it all start for you?
Well, Terra Culture started 12 years ago. When I got back to Nigeria, I wanted to do something different. I'm a lawyer by training. And when I got back, I'd been doing international law. So I felt the need to do something different. And I kind of like the arts. So
you've always had this thing for the arts?
Kind of latent, but increasingly I'm very passionate about it. Yes.
Well, you've obviously shown that passion. So what were the next critical steps? How did you get it going?
So with all businesses, the first thing I did was I had to put my thoughts on paper. That is critical because that allows you to brainstorm and see if what you're thinking is feasible and also sustainable. So I went about it talking to friends and family, and after doing my research, also visiting similar centers in Nigeria and abroad, I got my business proposal together, and the next stage was funding. I had to source the funds to put together the space that I wanted to create. And again, friends and family, the first people to go to, but if it's a lot of money, you have to approach banks.
Right.
So at that point, I approached a bank in Nigeria.
All right, and they got it going for you. But art is a really wide spectrum. So can you just help us appreciate what part of the arts Terra Culture is invested in?
We're an octopus, so we have our tentacles in like six different things. So we promote our languages. We teach Nigerian languages to foreigners as well as children. We're also into visual arts, so we sell Nigerian art. We also have an auction house called My Dream Terra Culture Auction House. We're one of two auction houses in Nigeria. And then we also have our restaurant where we sell Nigerian food. And the bookstore, we do book readings once a month. Known and up-and-coming authors, we kind of celebrate them.
Right.
And then we also have theatre. So we do live performances of stage plays.
Right, it's quite diverse. And
correct.
The big question, of course, is how profitable this is. I imagine you're not going to tell us specific numbers, but what can you tell those who perhaps have a thing for the arts and may want to get into this space?
I mean, you know, to be honest with you, the arts generally all over the world is not a lucrative business, so to speak. Typically, you get funding from international donors or even local donors. And in some countries, you have the countries put aside monies for arts and culture. Unfortunately, that's not the case in Nigeria. So what we've tried to do is to have this multifaceted center whereby every single unit generates enough funds. And it's that funding that has been able to drive the business for 12 years.
Right.
So I imagine if you were to do the business of maybe just visual arts or just bookselling, it might not be as lucrative. But because we have all of these disciplines, all of them interwoven,
it so tends it's really to, that mix that
it is that mix. And I would recommend that for anybody in future if they wanted to do something like that.
Speaking of the typical creative arts, so the painters, you know, tell us about that space in Nigeria. The creative people, how much support are they getting? How much money are they making?
Life is fluid. 10, 11 years ago, we've made significant progress. A couple of years back, our art pieces on average were between, you know, obviously depending on size and the name of the artist, from 40,000 to 100,000 naira average. But these days, I mean, we have some of our pieces have been sold abroad at auction houses for £500,000.
Wow.
Yes, El Anatsui, correct. And also, we have the likes of Bruce Onabrakpaya. We have the likes of Kolade Oshinowo. We have Grillo. We have a lot of big names selling. And then also the sort of like middle level, we have quite a bit. So things are beginning to change, and I think the auction houses have also been a force in driving the prices higher.
All right, so let's talk about the entrepreneurial side of this. Is it a lonely place for you as an entrepreneur? You are managing all of this, the theater arts, the creative arts, the restaurant. How much sleep do you get?
Well, we work very hard. That's the truth. I mean, the honest truth is there's no interest. We're not a financial institution. So we labor really hard. I think in some ways, people tend to think or undermine the amount of effort you need to put into any SME business in Nigeria.
Yeah.
We probably work harder than the bigger institutions that have funding.
Yeah.
So to stay alive, we basically have to keep at it. It hasn't been easy, but I guess nothing comes easy if you want to be successful at it.
Indeed. Of course, yes. We'll continue this conversation after the break. But Bolani, what would you like us to play for you today?
Well, I love Brymer. I'd love Mr. Waka Waka. You know, for those who know that I do musicals, we just had a musical called Waka, and he did the soundtrack for that.
All right, we'll bring that for you. And of course, we'll continue this conversation with Bolani Austin Peters right after the break.
Coming up on Mind Your Own Business.
You actually work harder than when you are an employee.
Right.
And people need to understand that. So you need the focus, you need the experience, organizational experience from previous institutions.
Right.
You need the financial discipline.
Right.
And you need to be ethically, you need to be very strong to drive an institution. Right.
Waka waka, on this journey where you dey, no forget tomorrow, Mr. Waka waka, Mrs. Waka waka, it you like la vida loca, it dey make you feel some type of way. Eventually, as time passes, when your run is done, tell me now who you gon' call. Eventually, as time passes, when your run is done, tell me now who you will call.
Welcome back. You're still listening to Mind Your Own Business, brought to you by UBA, Africa's Global Bank. And we're speaking to Bolani Austin Peters, the CEO of Terra Culture, and she's also invested in quite a few other things. We'll get to that in a little bit. But Bolani, let's first of all get your perspective on making that transition from a lawyer to an entrepreneur. What's the thought process behind that? Because I imagine that being a lawyer is one big investment already. So how do you make that move from being a lawyer to an entrepreneur?
Well, I started out as a lawyer. I finished law school 2000, yes. And I worked as a lawyer for my father. And then I went to England. I did a master's in international law at the London School of Economics and Political Science. Then I got a job in Switzerland. And then I worked for the UN.
Quite exotic.
Yeah, very exotic. I worked for at the Palais des Nations, working with the Human Rights Commission. So we did all the drafting of the conventions. From there, I moved to UNHCR, worked in Ethiopia with the refugees.
Wow, you've moved around quite a bit.
Yes, yes. And then thereafter, I moved because I started having children. So I moved to UNDP. I wanted a more stable job.
I
moved to Namibia. And then, anyhow, so I worked as a lawyer for quite a bit. And then we decided to come back home. And naturally, because my law was more international, it was not that relevant for Nigeria.
Right.
So I tried to practice as a lawyer, but I wasn't enjoying it.
Right.
That informed my transition into being an entrepreneur. I didn't set out to be an entrepreneur. It was because I wasn't enjoying practicing law in Nigeria.
Right. So in other words, you found your passion and you've kind of found a way to make a business out of it. Is that what you're saying?
Well, yes. I mean, at the end of the day, whenever you choose to set up any form of business, you have to be passionate about it. So what I did was I looked inwards and asked myself, what do I enjoy doing?
Right.
And I recognized that I enjoy literature.
So you literally stopped and said, this law thing is not working.
Yes.
What next?
Absolutely. I paused and I told my husband and he said, well, you know what? You have to find something that you enjoy doing. And that's why I started Terra Culture. I noticed that there was a gap.
Right.
There was no recreational or educational center where Nigeria's identity was being celebrated. So that's why I did that.
Right. Well, let's even talk about that Nigeria identity thing. A lot has been said about Nigeria taking over Africa in terms of the cultural aspect. Your thoughts about the potential for that?
Yeah, I mean, the potential for Nigeria to be a cultural imperialist is high. In terms of numbers, it's a game of numbers, really. That's why America dominated for so long. We're capable of doing it. I think that in a decade and a half, our music has started doing that already. Our fashion still needs a little bit of push, but I think we can also get there.
Mm.
We have started with theater, and we plan to take our plays abroad this year.
Right.
So I think that it's possible
right.
that Nigeria can become imperialist
right.
if we do choose to become one.
Speaking of productions, let's talk a bit about that 93 Days production that is coming up. What drove you to get into that story?
Well, I'm not a movie maker. I do stage.
Right.
But I was approached by Steve Gukas and Dr. Olakunri, a close friend, that I should, because of the nature of what we do, we're always producing at Terra Culture. So we have the machinery to do large-scale productions. So they came to me and asked that I be part of it. I wasn't interested initially, but when I read the script, it's actually more informative. It allows Nigerians to understand what actually went on in those 93 days when Ebola visited Nigeria.
Yeah.
And what it did for me was to showcase the heroes that we have in Nigeria,
right.
and for us to also recognize that we need to celebrate our own,
right.
because if we don't do it, somebody will come in and do it for us, like Fela on Broadway. And that's why I started musicals as well.
I hear you.
Yes.
Okay, let's move back to speaking to entrepreneurs now.
Yes.
And for those who are also maybe at work, they're itchy. They feel like they're not really enjoying the experience. Maybe a bit like you so many years ago.
Yes.
What would you say to those who are looking to take the type of steps that you've taken?
It's nice to be an entrepreneur. It's important for the growth of the nation that we have a very broad base of entrepreneurs because we are the ones that will drive the economy.
Yeah.
But that being said, not everybody has to be an entrepreneur. There are certain skill sets that are required for you to be a good or thriving entrepreneur.
Right.
So I think the first thing I would advise is you need to have some organizational experience. So having worked in institutions helped me to have corporate experience as well as diligence, which is very lacking in a lot of, if you look at Nigerian institutions or companies that come up, 2-3 years down the line, they're extinct. And I think it is because a lot of the founders or entrepreneurs have no discipline in terms of financial discipline,
right.
in terms of even just ethics, general ethics, work ethics, have to be at work at 8. As an entrepreneur, you actually work harder than when you're an employee.
Right.
And people need to understand that. So you need the focus. You need the experience, organizational experience from previous institutions.
Right.
You need the financial discipline.
Right.
And you need to be ethically, you need to be very strong to drive an institution.
Right. A big part of driving an institution is vision. And
yes.
is that a burden that you just have to continue to see where this business is going?
Yes.
How big a burden is that?
It's huge. That's why it's not, you know, everybody was, I'm an entrepreneur. It is huge. You need to really be clear about the fact that, number one, driving an institution requires constant tweaking. You have to be a visionary. Right. So where we started from, we started with a cultural space. Today we have both an auction house, we have a production company, we have a restaurant, which is one of the top restaurants in Nigeria, you know, and we have all of these other smaller things that we do underneath. That requires constant tweaking,
right,
constant innovation.
Right.
And if you think you can just come up with the one idea and stay with it for 20, 30 years without tweaking, it's almost you become a dinosaur and you just probably become extinct at some point.
All right, we'll of course hear more about your story. We've been speaking to Bolanle Austin-Peters, the CEO and founder of Terra Culture. But Bolanle, as we go into another break.
I love Olamide. Melo Melo.
All right.
Thank you.
So we'll bring that to you right now. We'll continue our conversation with Bolanle Austin-Peters right after this break. You're listening to Mind Your Own Business.
Coming up on Mind Your Own Business.
I get the sense that a lot of artists cutting across always think that because you're an artist, you should not be professional in appearance and in the branding of your goods and services. Mm. We have to change the conversation. Artists have to be seen like finance people. They have to be taken seriously because you're selling a skill and you're in a business.
I know the dengue, dengue. I know the post. Eh. My baby, give me biscuit. I want the sugar. It is you to me, but your barrel crochet we borrow barrel, borrow barrel crochet so Melo Melo, Melo Melo, la fairy Melo Melo, Melo Melo, la fair so Annie Melo Melo, Melo Melo, la fairy Melo Melo, Melo Melo, la fair so. Are you for Joe? Are you man? A kan be ko re mi a kan ke igi leyan pa mi nigba ko so nigba ko so la nigba ko so ro taye ro mi pin you stood by me. I know I made some mistakes but I don't get regrets. Now I know I go forget the cherish waiting I get. The very first day we met I told you how I felt. I lie I dey melt. My baby you're the best.
Welcome back. You're still listening to Mind Your Own Business, brought to you by UBA, Africa's Global Bank. We're speaking to Bolanle Austin-Peters, the founder and CEO of Terra Culture and BAP Productions. She's also involved in a feature movie, 93 Days. Bolanle, thank you so much for staying with us. As we begin to round up, a big part of your business is branding. So you put shows together, you need to make it appealing, you need to be able to bring the financing and everything else around it. Tell us about the importance of branding your product right.
That's very critical for any institution, as a matter of fact. You need to have that brand essence that people can relate to. And normally, in most cases, the founder drives the brand of the business. So it's important that people, you're believable and you're reliable and people expect a certain standard from your institution. So I think Terra Culture, like I said, it's 12 years now that we've been in business, and there's been a record of our performances, our standards, and the image of the founder and owner also is important in any business.
But imagine there's a cost to maintaining that brand, right? Do you get to a point where you have to make a tough decision between a business decision and something that you need to do to protect the brand?
I think invariably the brand protection is, it takes priority,
right,
simply because what you're doing is you're sowing for the future.
Right.
So it might not have immediate financial returns. In the long term, it does you well to invest in your brand. And in doing a lot of the promotions, as we were speaking earlier, because we have a strong presence out there now, it's easy for you to form partnerships and relationships with other institutions. So all of our plays, we get so many partners involved simply because they believe in the quality of what we're producing.
Right. So it was important to put that quality out, and that is now attracting more people you can collaborate with.
Absolutely.
Right. Very interesting point you're making there. So what next? What next for your business? Where do you see this going for you?
Well, for us, I think infrastructure is critical. We have to build our own theater, and we will do that because the model we're trying to adopt is to have spaces like you have abroad where you can see good performances every weekend. Or
like Nigeria's Broadway.
Absolutely.
All right.
It's coming very shortly. And then BAP Productions, our desire is to keep on churning out excellent material, both on stage and in the movie theaters as well. We also intend to export our products. Like I said, we'll be showing outside of Nigeria. For the first, our stage plays haven't been traveling a lot. We're changing that by the grace of God this year. So,
all right. All the best as you continue to do that. But
thank you.
Where do you see the creative industry in Nigeria going? You've come a long way. We've talked about music, for instance. Yeah. Everyone knows about Nollywood. And now you are invested in the arts. So, and you're also in stage productions. Your thoughts about where all of that is going?
I believe strongly the creative industry will be probably one of the leading drivers of Nigeria's economy in the next couple of years. We have the numbers to bring in the revenue. We have the talent. What was lacking initially was government support. And because the individuals involved have recognized that they're capable of doing this with or without government support, because the game of numbers.
Right.
The music industry has done it. Nobody believed in it. Nollywood has started turning around as well. And theater has started. Fashion has started. And if you look at what is going on in Nigeria today, everybody's talking about diversifying our economy.
Yeah.
Oil is not going to sustain us. It never has. Mm-hmm. It will never be the saving grace for Nigeria. So if you're smart, you better join the creative industry.
All right. And let's talk about what's your advice to those creative people out there. Yeah. So we have somebody who is listening now. He has this thing for the arts. Maybe he's a painter, but he just doesn't see that future, that financial future for him. What's your message to that person?
Well, for the thing is, you have to become excellent at whatever you do. So your products have to match any other anywhere else in the world. We can't have this Nigerian quality or standard thing. It has to stop.
So it has to think global.
Absolutely. You have to think global. And the second thing is, you have to invest time, because things only evolve with time. And then you have to be professional. I get the sense that a lot of artists cutting across always think that because you're an artist, you should not be professional in appearance and in the branding of your goods and services. Mm. We have to change the conversation. Artists have to be seen like finance people. They have to be taken seriously because you're selling a skill and you're in a business.
Right.
And I think that is critical for artists.
You don't have a background in theater arts, and building that professionalism, obviously education is critical there. How do you understand this whole business of the arts?
I guess it wasn't me.
So you just have it, in a sense. It's a gift.
I got it. That's it. It's a gift.
All right, Bolanle, as we begin to round up, we always like to have our guests leave some really critical tips to budding entrepreneurs. So what are your parting words to those who want to go into the really tough and challenging world of business in Nigeria?
First, be professional. Your goods must be of international standards. You have to be very focused. You can't jump from one thing to the other. And then you have to invest in time. You know, nothing happens overnight. The successes that you hear of other people's exploits today, they probably spent 10 years sowing those seeds. So I think for me, those would be focus, time, professionalism, and international standards. Those are the four things that I would have at the back of my mind if I'm doing anything.
Very wise words, very useful words. And thank you so much for spending your time with us. Bolanle Austin Peters, of course, is the founder and CEO of Terra Culture and BAP Productions. And that's where we end our show for this week.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for listening. We'll come back to you next week with another program, a brand new guest, and a lot more insight into the world of business in Nigeria. Thank you for listening. I'm Wole Famiwa. Good morning.
For inquiries on Mind Your Own Business, please contact UBA Customer Fulfillment Center by calling these numbers: 01-280-8822, 01-631-9822, and 0700-225-5822. Facebook.com/UBA Group. twitter.com/UBA Group, live chat www.ubagroup.com, and you can also email cfc@ubagroup.com. Today's business tips by Bolale Austin Peters: focus, time, professionalism, and international standards. Mind Your Own Business is brought to you by UBA, Africa's Global Bank.